Greetings. In the name of the Most High, YHWH.
Rastafari. HalleluJ'YAH, SELASSIE. ADONAY, YHWH. Shabbat Shalom. Summa Salam. Sabbath peace to each and every one. The blessed eve of the seven-day Shabbat, that blessed eve of the true seven-day Sabbath, that true seven-day Sabbath, Simba Salam, as we say in the Amharic, Shabbat Shalom, in the Hebrew, Sabbath peace and blessings. It's been about 7 days since the previous seven-day Shabbat, the previous Shabbat, which happened to fall on the 8th day assembly, the Shemini Atzeret, the 8th day assembly, after 7 days of tabernacles. Yes, 7 days of Sukkot. We said, Hag Sukkot, Sameach, in the Hebrew, blessed tabernacles, blessed 8th day assembly that happened to fall on the true 7 day Sabbath. Almost 7 complete days. Once again, that ultimate divine number of 7. Also, on the divine number 8, which means to build Yahweh's kingdom, that is Jah kingdom, as above, so below, and from within, the true Mount Zion, that true Mount Zion, the promised land, is a state of mind. The true promised land, that slice of Mount Zion, is a state of mind. Divine words, Jah words, through Majek Fajek, great African reggae legend, Majek Fajek, the promised land. Yes, I. Shabbat Shalom. Simba Salam. Sabbath peace to each and every one. As above, so below. From within, Eliyai, Selassie, is Majek Fajek with the promised land, the state of mind, and I. In this time of Armageddon, more obvious signs of the times, the world at war, the Zionist powers, Israeli state governments, yes, I, fighting against Hamas, of these radicals, nation war against the nation, the people are divided more than ever, religiously, politically, racially. Hope you are ready for the true promised land. Yes, I acknowledge the ancient and modern day promised land. A good part of that promised land of ancient and modern day Jerusalem, Palestine, Arabia, Mother Africa, Ethiopia, Judeo-Christian Ethiopia, the monarchy of King David, and his King David, HalleluJ'YAH, Rastafari, Yai Selassie. We speak of the true Israel, true faithful Israel, the body of Messiah. the core body of Christ, to His Majesty, the one true King of Kings in Christos, the returns, Mashiach. Sigh. Returns, HaMOSHIYAH. Right now they fighting over that geographical land, that original land given to the great prophet Abraham, to Yitzhak and Yaakov, through Ibrahim or Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. Part of Africa, in the core part of Mother Africa, Ethiopia, Sudan, ancient Kemet, this ancient Egypt, all of Arabia, the postmodern day region considered that so-called Israeli state, that Zionist state, the true Zion, the present Zion, is within the heart. Wherever the Ark of the Covenant, that true Ark of the Covenant, the monarchy of David through Solomonic dynasty, from ancient Israel to Judeo-Christian Ethiopia, that lineage of Yehuda, the tribe of Judah, I am known, let's say it, the Most High, YHWH. Many of I and I should pray the innocent civilians on so-called Israeli soil and Palestinian soil, even more so Palestinian, Lebanese, now Syria, tensions rising up, Iran, others pronounce Iran, backing Hamas and Palestine. This holy war just broke out on the 8th Day Assembly last weekend on Shabbat. It's the true promised land, state of mind, in these present renewed covenant times. We have nation war against nation, bloodshed, even innocent bloodshed over a piece of land that once belonged to more of an original indigenous people. The roots of all nations go back. I repeat, the roots of all nations, Jew and Gentile, go back to Mother Africa, Ethiopia. Mount Zion, the true Zion, not the Zionist powers, not the Vatican, not wicked Babylon system. The truth of Jah kingdom, Yahweh's kingdom, Hashem Yeshua HaMashiach. For those of I and I who partake in the herbal meditation, let us begin. I once again, the African reggae legend. Many great legends, right out of the motherland. Thanks. We have Alpha Blondie, his classic roots reggae songs, just like the great legend, Bob Marley. The great legend himself, Bob Marley, a.k.a. Wahana Selassie, as we say, in that royal Amharic, or the Amharic language, the light of the Trinity. Wahana, the light of the Trinity, Selassie, Liai, Selassie. Thanks and praises. Thanks and Isis. All right, so.
This thing, Sean.
All right, good thanks. Brother Spence, on the blessed Friday evening, Sabbath Eve, many of I and I say, once again, Shabbat Shalom, Samba Salam, and Sabbath peace to each and everyone. To all true Yahudim and faithful Israelites of heart as true Christians, ethnic Jew or Gentile, that is ethnic Hebrew Israelites or Gentile according to flesh, we are one through His Majesty in Christos. We are one through Jah Kingdom and HaMoshiyah, or the King of Kings in Christ, Yahshua HaMoshiyah. Give thanks. But now you have all this division, all this Babylonian Zionism propaganda influence and mind control over the masses. When people think about the name Israel, have mercy on Jah, Yahweh Elohim. When they hear the name Israel, they only think about the postmodern day so-called Israeli state called Israel. And sometimes we still call it Israel because it still is a great portion, I repeat, it still is a great portion of that physical land of Israel, the land of Israel. When we take more time to meditate and study the book of the great prophets, that is the book of the prophets, Ezekiel chapter 38, we see the land of Israel, the ancient and modern day land of Yahshua. That land shall be attacked in prophecy. That prophetical Salika. That prophetical connection with Gog and Magog, the ancient lands or nation of Gog and Magog, in that connection with Russia and ancient to modern day Persia, identified with Iran, or as others pronounce, Iran. Another great Islamic nation supporting these other Islamic and Muslim nations. And here I go, on this one love vibration. I almost get people together for a hot second to hold hands and sing Kumbaya, but now so much division. When you hear about the so-called Jewish Sabbath, you hear about the so-called Jewish Sabbath on a Friday Eve, and I was just moments ago just watching the live stream, mainstream news, or the Babylonian news live stream about protests, pro-Palestine, pro-Israeli, or so-called pro-Israel, but I say Israeli, because true Israel is something different with an accurate interpretation of both the Tanakh, the same original Hebrew scriptures from the Tanakh, and what we know as the Bible today, an accurate translation from the original Hebrew, the Aramaic and Amharic, the Greek to the English, the Latin to the Spanish. We have these different translations, but it is one Ha'alohim through Jahweh in that great book of life, from Bereshith or from Genesis to Revelation and so forth. And I and I cannot give up striving to be that peacemaker. The Most High YHWH, the Most High Jah, has called I and I to be, for all of us to be the peacemakers. Thus saith Rabbi Yehoshua, blessed are the peacemakers. Most High Yahweh Jah, Rastafari, say, it's HaMoshiyah and the first advent, the one true prophet of all prophets, the one true rabbi of all rabbis, the one true imam amongst all imams. Since blessed are the peacemakers, not those who cause division through warfare, start these religious wars. We see corruption on both sides of so-called Israeli soil, and so-called Palestinian soil, so-called Hamas. The Gaza Strip is no more, just like I predicted days ago. And I have the actual audible recording evidence, along with my beloved queen, Pamela, my spiritual wife, my love. She heard me and she witnessed just a few days ago, earlier this Shabuah, or earlier this week, that I said, watch the Israeli military, or watch the Israeli government send their military to destroy and wipe out all of Gaza and Palestine. Now they're going to war with Hezbollah and Lebanon, now Syria. It is not looking pretty, but these things have rightfully got my attention in the past 7 days, but now it's time to seven ourselves. You hear about the so-called Jewish Sabbath from a secular perspective, but your so-called Jewish Sabbath is the 7-day Shabbat, is Yahweh's Sabbath, the Jehovah's Sabbath, Allah or Allah's Sabbath, that you send it and its origin. We also say Simbat Salam in the Amharic, the Salam in the Arabic as well, these other original Afro-Shemitic languages. So we break down the barrier, we break down the barriers, we chant down the walls of wicked Babylon system through confusion, that try to separate us, that try to keep us divided through the dark side of organized religion. This creates more division and more confusion, more of that spiritual bondage to keep people in that spiritual Egypt, that mental slavery that even Bob Marley spoke of in this time. And Matt Chappelle, it was silly. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves, there's none but I self, can free my own minds. None but ourselves, as the people, can free our own minds. You must free yourself, look within yourself, and also repent. Repent before the Almighty One, but also to be truly born again or begotten again. You must look within yourself, find the true living Elohim, that true living God, through Messiah, through Christ, within self. No blasphemy. We take more time to really meditate and study the divine words of Yahshua HaMashiach. I and I, Black Lord and Savior, Yahshua HaMashiach, a.k.a. Justice Christ. Jesus Christ, the Son. Not the Antichrist Jesus, that Antichrist Jesus, Romanism, mixed in with dispensationalism, got the people confused. They're thinking the only group of ethnic Jews or Yahudim or Israelites on the face of the earth in these last of last days is in the connection with the modern Israeli state or Zionist state. Now, with all that being said, we still pray for the poor victims. The numbers increase as days went by. 1,300 to over 1,300. And then last time I checked, over 1,400 Palestinian deaths. They say their main target is Hamas. I'm not saying that it's not, but it's just, what's up with the people not having any way to escape, even into Egypt, that southern border of Palestine, even that Gaza Strip, they blocked off. It's like, what do we choose? Some people can see the injustice, the same injustice that's been going on for quite some time. Palestinian people, some Arab descent or Hittites, Middle Eastern descents, they were converts to Islam, different forms of Islam as Muslims, many good Muslims and true Muslims, but say the same thing on so-called Israeli soil, in the land of Israel. You have many genuine fellow Torah observants amongst the Orthodox Yahudim, what we call the other Jews, who are true, faithful Orthodox Yahudim, and who are also anti-Zionists, who practice more of a pure form of legit Orthodox Judaism. We even use that term, Judaism, but yes, for those that see, just like any faithful Muslim, you know, fellow Muslim or Muslim of heart, despite what dimension of Islam or, you know, so-called Islam, not to get into Islam and Salika, not to get into Islamism and schisms, because there are many forms of Islamisms where you create an imbalance through the dark side of organized religion. It is not based on the accurate interpretation of both the Bible and the Quran. You have more false religions that creep in, other types of ism and schisms, through extremisms, and then you have evil against evil, despite the justification of those on one side who are more downpressed, being victims, I repeat, being victims of a slow genocide that's taking place. Y'all don't hear me though.
Yes, sir. My lady just got back, so we shall continue. This week's Torah portion goes back to Bereshith, in the beginning, the book of Genesis. Yes, there's an oppressive, corrupt government give leeway to actual terrorism, as they tell us through the media, decapitating infants and killing children and kidnapping people, raping women. I don't want to even think about it, especially on Shabbat, but that happened on a Shabbat. Lord have mercy, Jah. Where is the hedge of protection there? Where is that spiritual hedge of protection that was once there? To legit messianic Yahudim and legit Orthodox Yahudim,
the true anti-Zionist, Orthodox, and Messianic Yahudim, and fellow spiritual Israelites, and that fulfillment in Messiah, yes, they still have somewhat of that hedge of protection because of components like that. But the majority of so-called citizens are just like American citizens in this melting pot. It's a world of secularism. Ones who call abominations good. Ones who call evil good. Who call good evil. Yes, I.
It's about the accurate interpretation of scriptures within Jah, Word, and Truth in this great book of life. It's not about organized religion. It's not about Christianity that is Gentile or counterfeit Christianities outside of the original Ethiopian Tewahedo Orthodox Church, or that original Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Christian faith. In parallel with the fulfilled Israelite faith of the Nazarenes in HaMoshiyah, and now the return Christos, the return Mashiach, the King of Kings. Humble thyself. Grab your Bible scriptures. And I am sipping the red wine in moderation. I don't drink that much when it comes to alcohol. I'm a baldhead Rasta. As a fulfilled Nazarene, I have not taken upon the Nazarite vow. So I sip upon the fruit of the vine from time to time in moderation. That's right. Then keep Jah's commandments. All right, shalom, shalom. Brother Spence, once again, the next couple days on this blessed first day, so-called Sunday of a new Shavuot Tov, we are dealing, I repeat, we are dealing with the same weekly Shabbat.
Rewind.
All right, shalom, shalom. Brother Spence, once again, the next couple days on this blessed first day, so-called Sunday of a new Shavuot Tov, we are dealing, I repeat, we are dealing with the same weekly Shabbat.
Rewind.
Shalom, shalom. Brother Spence, once again, on this blessed Sunday, so-called Sunday afternoon, blessed first day, Shavuot Tov, still regarding the now previous, but to those who have been listening in this particular YouTube video lecture in the past few minutes regarding the same weekly Torah portion in the beginning, Bereshith, as we say in the Hebrew, Bereshith, or the book of Genesis, in the beginning. So grab your Bible scriptures, your Tanakh, or Torah scriptures. Yes, I. Yesterday, on Shabbat, that true seven-day Sabbath, it was Yahweh's will. We say the name Hashem's will. But it was Jah's will that I and I took part in another chamber, another dimension when it comes to Jah works. For Jah works must be done. So I and I played with my fellow born-again brethren, my fellow reggae ambassador, known as the ambassador, the chosen few.
amongst other fellow brethren and sistren. I repeat, fellow brethren and sistren up on stage at Elmwood Park yesterday morning to the early yesterday afternoon. As Jah teaches, Yahuwah teaches through Christ, Yeshua, or through Jesus Christ, the Messiah, our Lord and Savior in the first advent, to do good on the Sabbath. We still said Shabbat Shalom, Simba Salam. But to do good on that true seven-day Sabbath. So I and I, as the conga man and backup percussionist, was on stage to play the one love music, to truly carry out Jah works. And right here, right now, other things took place regarding family, late Friday afternoon to the early evening, still regarding this recent situation in my personal life with my woman and her beloved mother, her earthly mother, who has passed barely even a month ago. But right here, right now, let us no longer procrastinate. But the word of the Most High, I repeat, the word of the Most High, Yahuwah, Jehovah, must go on. Selah.
Yes, I. Yesterday, they had the seasonal Go Fest right here in my blessed hometown of Roanoke, Virginia. Downtown Roanoke, Virginia, at the Go Fest, which happened to be at Elmwood Park downtown, where the infamous and legendary Ziggy Marley performed this past summer. All due respect. But right here, right now, on this back porch of our blessed humble abode, where I and I had the tabernacle or the sukkah set up barely even 2 weeks ago, you hear the mystical sound, the chimes blowing in the breeze. Yes, I, right here, right now, I and I and we take more time to meditate. Discipline ourselves once again. Grab your Bible scriptures, your Torah scriptures. Let us go back to the beginning in Bereshith or the book of Genesis. Thanks. Thus saith the Most High Yahuwah, Jehovah. In the beginning, HaElohim created the heavens and the earth. In the beginning, Almighty God created the heavens and the earth. Verse 2. And the earth came to be formless and empty, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of Elohim was moving on the face of the waters. Selah. Verse 3. And HaElohim, Almighty God, Al Shaddai, the Most High Yahweh, said unto I and I, let light come to be, or let there be light. And light came to be. Abracadabra. Verse 4. And HaElohim saw the light, that it was good. And Elohim separated the light
from the darkness. Selah. Verse 5. And Ha'Elohim called the light day, the darkness he called night. And there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, one day, one complete cycle. The beginning, there was darkness, the evening to evening. As we know today, many of I and I know today, an average Hebraic daily cycle from sundown to sundown, that 24-hour cycle. Verse 6. And Elohim said, let an expanse come to be in the midst of the waters, and let it be separate. HalleluJ'YAH. Let it separate the waters from the waters. Verse 7. And Elohim, or Almighty God, made the expanse and separated the waters which were under the expanse from the waters which were above the expanse, and it came to be so. Verse 8. And Ha'Elohim called the expanse the heavens, and there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, the second day. Another cycle. Verse 9. And Ha'Elohim, the Most High Jah, said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it came to be so. Speak into existence. Verse 10. And Elohim called the dry land earth, and the collection of the waters he called the seas. And Elohim saw that it was good. HalleluJ'YAH. Verse 11. And Elohim said, let the earth bring forth grass, the plant that yields seed, and the fruit tree that yields fruit according to its kind, whose seed is in itself on the earth. And it came to be so. Verse 12. And the earth brought forth grass, the plant that yields seed according to its kind, and the tree that yields fruit, whose seed is in itself according to its kind. And Ha'Elohim saw that it was good. Verse 13. And there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, the third day. Selah. Verse 14. And Ha'Elohim said, let lights come to be in the expanse of the heavens, the celestials, to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and appointed times, and for days and years. HalleluJ'YAH. Verse 15. And let them be for lights in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth. And it came to be so. Verse 16. And Elohim made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. Verse 17. And Ha'Elohim set them in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth. Right here on Mother Earth, the Father's creation. Verse 18. And to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And how Elohim saw that it was good. Verse 19. And there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, the fourth day. Verse 20. And how Elohim, or Almighty God, said, let the waters teem with shoals of living beings, and let birds fly above the earth and on the face of the expanse of the heavens. Verse 21. And how Elohim, Ixiavier, created the great sea creatures and every living being that moves, with which the waters teemed according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And how Elohim saw that it was good. Verse 22. And Elohim blessed them, saying, be fruitful and increase, and fill the waters and the seas, and let the birds increase on the earth. Verse 23. And there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, the fifth day. Verse 24. And how Elohim, Ixiavier, the Elohim said, let the earth bring forth the living being according to its kind, livestock and creeping creatures, and beasts of the earth according to its kind. And it came to be so. Verse 25. And how Elohim made the beasts of the earth according to its kind, livestock according to its kind, and all that creep on the earth according to its kind. And how Elohim saw that it was good. HalleluJ'YAH. Verse 26. And Elohim said, let us make mankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over all the creeping creatures that creep on the ground. Verse 27. And Elohim created the man in his image. In the image of Elohim, he created him, male and female. He created them. HalleluJ'YAH. Verse 28. And how Elohim blessed them. Elohim, or Almighty God, said to them, be fruitful and increase, and fill the earth and subdue it, and rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over all creeping creatures on the earth. Verse 29. And how Elohim said, see, I have given you every plant that yields seed, which is on the face of all the earth, and every tree whose fruit yields seed. To you, it is for food. HalleluJ'YAH. Verse 30. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the heavens, and to every creeping creature on the earth in which there is a living being, every green plant is for food. And it came to be so. Verse 31. And how Elohim, or Almighty God, Al Shaddai, saw all that he had made, and see, it was very good. And there came to be evening, and there came to be morning, the sixth day.
I got to go now. They're calling me on stage.
Thank you. beginning. In the beginning, God created God the heaven and the earth. The heaven and the earth. And God said, and God said, light, and there was light, and there was light. And God said, and God said, the water began unto a firmament, and let the dry land appear. And God called the dry land, earth, 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 earth.
Thank you.